very well done. I feel this is very well done.
How are you doing, guys? You alright?
Yay!
My name is Alex Page, and tonight, you lucky people are going to be popping my stand-up cherry. And just like everyone's first time, I'm going to be making some awkward eye contact, hoping I'm doing it right, and praying it doesn't go in the shitter. But a little bit about me, I was born with web feet. Now you may think that would make me a naturally gifted swimmer, but because it's in the 1 foot, I just swim in circles. That explains my life, really. I was also a very large kid growing up, which is no surprise, really. I do come from quite a large family. I say this because my granddad's put a bit of weight on recently. Yeah, my nan's been using him as an ashtray. So when I say I was a very large kid growing up, what I really mean is I was the first person at school to have a pair of tits. You know, they say beauty is subjective. Well, in my case, it was very fucking subjective. But you know, everyone at school was really fun and supportive about it, and to keep me part of the groups, they gave me some really cool nicknames, you know, like Sugar Tits or Fat Cunt. I've been trying to lose some weight recently. I got myself one of them Fitbits, but I tell you what, they ain't half misleading though, because I thought they track like your GPS movement or some bollocks like that, but what they actually do is track the swings of your arms. Well, this information was very useful to me, because up until that point I've been assuming I was doing about 10 miles before I even got out of bed in the morning. Now, some of the ladies in the audience who didn't quite get that one, that was a joke about me excessively wanking. Talk about highbrow comedy, am I right? Also, I tried all the diets out there, and I thought, I've got to be honest with you, the only thing I've really found out is never, ever get into a relationship with a vegetarian, because at the end of the day, they're just a vegan with commitment issues. I've also been told I take very long and awkward drink breaks, which reminds me of this really funny story, actually. Sorry, 1 second. You know what I'm sick of? PC culture. Now, bear with me, I can see some of your faces in the audience. What's this white man gonna say? Well, ladies and gentlemen, I called somebody a nonce the other day. And that's right, a nonce. And someone turned around to me, dead serious, was like, you can't say that anymore, and that is an offensive term. Who the fuck do they think I'm going to offend? The pedos? The fucking pedos? I'm sure it's terms like that that make Jimmy Savile turn in his grave. I mean, I know they're an oppressed group of society, but I thought for obvious reasons. Now, I want to quickly see a show of hands as well. How many of you got any older siblings? Wow, you can really fucking tell who ain't. You're missing that trauma in your eyes. Now, the reason I ask this is because I myself have an older brother, and you know, there's about 8 or 9 years between us, which is a considerable amount of time, or as my mum would say in the words of Bob Ross, just one of her happy little accidents. But I mentioned my brother because he'd done this really fun thing for years, where he just beat the shit out of me. You know, the classics like pushing me into a sticking ambush, beating me with a lightsaber. Sadly, not a real one though. Fracturing the skull, and my favourite one, leading me into a river to drown. It's fine. I could swim in circles, guys. You know what the most evil thing this bastard done to me? He convinced me that, you know, like the goodie badge you get at the end of a birthday party? Yeah, he convinced me they're not actually for me, they're for the guests who couldn't make it. So, me, being the gullible dickhead I am, get back, waltz up to him, and hand it off to him. 5 fucking years that went on for! You know, we grow up, and it's this point of time, he goes and joins the army, and I get fatter. He receives years of special forces training. I discovered porn. He was a trained killer. I was 6th prestige in Call of Duty. But, you know, I wanted my revenge. I wanted payback. But I couldn't take him in a physical one-to-one. Oh, no, 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 no. I had to play to my strengths, which it later turns out I sadly don't have any of. Yet, I still devised a plan so good, I wouldn't be the one hurting him. And it was real simple. All I had to do was create a series of elaborate events that would slowly encourage him to do one more tour. Now, you heard that right, ladies and gentlemen. One more tour. Now, I'd done this just enough times for him to develop PTSD. Who's the bitch now? Stop the pranks. But no, all jokes aside, he is fine. Apart from Guy Fawkes Night, he still really struggles. I don't know, maybe I went a bit too far. Now, fuck him. Anyway, I've been Alex Page, you have been wonderful. Have a great night.